And the first speech will be delivered by Mrs. Judit Varga, Hungarian Minister of Justice. And she will present us the issue of digitalization and sovereignty from a Hungarian point of view. And she will also highlight the responsibility of leaders to ensure a safe digital transitions for European citizens, which is of key importance. Madam Minister, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Honourable Member of the European Parliament. Dear Madam Commissioner, dear State Secretary over in the online sphere, dear Director, dear Committee Chair, Mr. Banky, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it is, I think, a very good example why we need to talk about digitalization, because we needed 5 minutes to solve this technical problem at the beginning of this conference. But thank you very much for the staff to manage it properly. So, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to express my gratitude for accepting our invitation to our third discussion on the Conference of the Future of Europe. Commissioner Gabriel, State Secretary Zacharias, Director Navas, and Chairman Banky, thank you for joining us today. Our aim was to organize a comprehensive discussion on digitalization, so today's conference will give voice to both institutional actors and members of the business and scientific community, and I would like to give a warm welcome to them as well. While government measures and safety restrictions naturally hindered the cooperation, with mass vaccination programs underway in Hungary with success, I hope that the conference on this on the future of Europe will proceed in full speed from now on. It must also be highlighted that due to the discipline of the Hungarian people and the efforts of the government, now we are able to hold this conference, at least partly, in person. We are pleased to hold our third dialogue on the future of Europe event, which have traditionally by now taken place in this beautiful historic building of the Hungarian National Assembly. And this is also symbolic because we are confident that national parliaments must play a key role in the events of the conference. These great halls hold many memories of the Hungarian history, and they remind us about our past and also the duties ahead of us. I consider the conference as a historic chance to rediscover our roots and the spirit of the initial cooperation between European nations with a renewed sense of ambition. It is indeed the duty of our generation to preserve our heritage while we progress to ever-changing future. Every age carries unique potential and extraordinary challenges. In the latter half of the 20th century, a digital revolution, also known as the Third Industrial Revolution, has begun, profoundly changing the lives of nations and billions of people around the world. The invention of computers and the internet paved the way for new opportunities and changed the nature of working, traveling, learning, entertainment, or even shopping. It fundamentally transformed economies, societies, and cultures, including the European Union itself. While most inventions usually impact only one industry, few inventions brought horizontal, comprehensive changes to the way societies function. Digitalization is one of these, and as many say, contains limitless opportunities. Yet, with every key invention comes a key obligation for governments to evaluate its long-term consequences in terms of society, economic, and culture. So, in the process of preparing itself for the future, Europe must also address the challenges the future may hold. With the tool of digitalization, Europe must find a way to make it a force for the common good while keeping it within the domain of public safety. As member states, we write the European Union story. It's time to take our future into our hands. We must ensure that the digital European Union that we build works for the benefit of European citizens. One of the most important features of sovereignty is the freedom of action and the ability to decide about our own fate. Considering that we continue to live a significant part of our lives online, we have to ensure that the principle of sovereignty can prevail not only in the physical world, but also in the digital world. Since their creation in the mid-2000s, social media platforms have begun increasingly influential in the digital world. At the beginning, they carry the promising potential for democracies worldwide, the potential of becoming enablers of free speech, thereby enhancing the quality of public discourse. By winning the trust of people, They have amassed billions of users around the world, capturing the attention of citizens globally each day. They rapidly conquer the world, just as fast food and sugary beverages did. But the thrill is typically gone once people realize the drawbacks of these products. In recent times, as social media platforms prospered, many users began to grow disillusioned. Data breaches and scandals have become commonplace. Platforms escalated the spread of fake news, while citizens experienced increasing censorships, in many cases restricting freedom of speech. We know now that social media platforms collect and analyze our personal data, habits, behaviors, opinions, and consumption. Instead of taking the role of a gatekeeper, they actively influence users. While citizens agree that our most personal information should belong to our own sphere of sovereignty, our online private space seems to be continuously shrinking. Perhaps the biggest challenge of our modern times is whether we will be able to control technology or technology will control our lives. The warnings of experts and the worries of European citizens cannot go unnoticed. Citizens entrusted us with the task of protecting their interests. As leaders, we must respond to their worries, we must address these issues, and we must defend our common achievements, including the freedom of speech and digital independence. To this end, the Ministry of Justice of Hungary has established the Digital Freedom Committee last March, which aims to make the operation of transnational technological companies and their data management more transparent. The committee invites users to follow its activities and to suggest other topics for consideration via its dedicated website. The Digital Freedom Committee prepared a white paper with the aim of summarizing and presenting to our citizens the issues and problems related to the current regulation, based on the experience of government bodies and those who apply the law. Freedom of expression and protection of privacy, data protection, taxation and copyright protection, enforcement of criminal law, child protection, and issues related to national sovereignty are among the main priority areas which are covered by the white paper. The committee has already met numerous times, exchanging views on how digital freedom can prevail in times of emergency and what the necessary measures can be to strengthen data protection and the freedom of expression online. We still have a long way to go, dear ladies and gentlemen, but we will do our best to ensure that our citizens can use the online environment consciously and safely, where their fundamental rights and personal data are well protected. Hungary has long understood that we have to tread our own path in order to preserve what is dear to us. We believe that the same laws should apply both offline and online, the same rules and the same law. This is what guarantees the normal way of life of a society. At last, more and more countries are recognizing the urgency of addressing this issue with independent national legislation to regulate big tech companies and social media. Examples include Germany, France, Poland, and in fact, even the EU as a whole. We are pleased to share the findings of the Digital Freedom Committee with all our partners. We hope that in the future, it could serve as a benchmark for member states who wish to take steps in order to guarantee the safety and well-being of European citizens in the online world. We encourage all member states to evaluate how to best ensure their citizens' safety in an increasingly digital European Union. Therefore, we welcome that at the end of 2020, the European Commission presented two legislative proposals, the so-called Digital Services Act and the Digital Markets Act, the DSA and the DMA, aimed at creating a single set of rules for social media platforms across the EU. If adopted, the proposal will be directly applicable in all member states and so will have an impact on the scope of each national regulation. Although the adoption of the drafts is still pending, regulatory efforts are well advanced. Hungary is actively involved in the negotiation of the legislative package. The regulation of social media platforms is inevitable, what not even the platforms themselves would deny. It is inevitable, not only for the protection and enforcement of certain fundamental rights, but also because digital market players, given that this market is now global, must also comply with competition rules. Big tech companies are often able to restrict or even make competition impossible by abusing their monopoly position. Therefore, it seems justified to guide the market players also through competition rules. The EU is on the right track with the digital package, the Commissioner. Examples show that states may have a hard time when regulating alone. This is a field where a firm European answer or international cooperation is needed in order to counter the hegemony of social media and guarantee fairness and objectivity. When Mr. Thierry Breton, French Commissioner, visited Budapest, he asked me to wait with the Hungarian legislation as long as we have a European one. So I was happily agreeing to it because here we have a common European approach. Dear ladies and gentlemen, Europe is on the road to recovery. It is our duty to rebuild Europe stronger, safer, and ready to face the next digital challenge. To make digitalization a force for the common good, we have to place citizens at the center of Europe's technological advancement. We cannot let the pace of technological advancement overtake our ability to guarantee the well-being of our citizens. To meet their expectations and defend their fundamental rights, we must rise to the challenge and act swiftly. Europe must lead by example and become the pioneer of protecting fundamental rights in the age of digital freedom. As the world changes, the legal context must change too. We have to keep up with the times. In a smart world, we have to build a smart union too, and not an unrealistic ever closer. In the smart EU, only those fields should be dealt with on an EU level, which are really much worse coordinating together than on a purely national level. Challenges must be tackled at EU level where it is reasonable and at national level where it is desirable and possible. I believe legislating on the monopoly of big tech companies is an issue where coordinated measures are not only reasonable, but indispensable too. Dear ladies and gentlemen, today we will hear the point of view of distinguished politicians, business people, and academics on how digitalization affects their field of expertise. And I hope that today's conference will be a fruitful contribution to the European legislation too. Thank you very much for your attention.